Hello, everyone, and welcome to Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. I'm your host, Patrick LeBlanc, and today I have a very special guest with me, Miquella. Miquella, how are you?
Hey, good. Thanks. How are you?
Thanks for coming. So, Miquella, before we get into all the great stuff that you're going to share with us, why don't you tell the people who you are and what you do?
Definitely. So my name is Miquella de Boer. I'm a product manager on the One Lake team leading the shortcuts area.
Yeah. One Lake, so important to Fabric, right? It's the foundation of Fabric. So I've been hearing some stuff about these new features and capabilities that's coming out. One in particular that really excites me a lot, CSV to Delta. Why don't you tell people what it is?
Yeah, definitely. So if you're familiar with shortcuts, right, it's just a very easy way of setting up, and it's actually just like shortcutting your data into One Lake. It's all virtual and we're not copying over your data. But while you're doing that, it's always just the exact data that is coming in and out. And now we've added the capability of applying transformations while you're actually setting up the shortcuts. Yes. And so say, for example, you have a bunch of CSV files and you want to start working with that in Fabric. All the engines that you have in Fabric, if you want to query your data, build your Power BI reports, it all works on Delta tables, right? So in order for me to work on Delta tables, I first have to set up maybe like a notebook, do the transform. I also then have to do change detection on those files, and that is very difficult, right? So I have to see if the CSV files have been updated, if there's new ones there, deleted, to make sure that my Delta table will always reflect that same information. Yeah. And this is where the shortcut transforms are coming in. So, because shortcuts always keeps your data in sync with sync and source. So it will take care of all the change detection for you.
That's what I was just about to ask you. So I don't have to do a whole bunch. Once this is set up, data's just streaming in for me, right? It handles it.
Yeah,
and so,
exactly.
But why would I use this? Why, right? I mean, I can write code. I can use notebooks and do this. Why would I do it?
So it's like ease of use, like anyone can use it. It's so easy to set up. So if you don't have that experience, it's easy to do it. But also if you just don't want to manage all these different pipelines and all these different experiences, you can just do it directly inside a shortcut.
Got it. Okay. So we know what it is. We know why we should use it. Let's check it out. Let's see how it works.
Yeah, definitely. Right. Let me show you. So here I'm in the lake house and I have a bunch of CSV files in here. So I have my daily sales inside there. So you can see here, I have a couple of sales records that are coming in.
Yep.
And I want to like make that into a Delta table. So what I will do is just, I will just start opening up a shortcut. It's just a regular shortcut experience. So from here, I'm just going to create a shortcut. I can connect to any sources. So it just not only works with One Lake sources, any of the external sources is work with too. All I have to do is just select the folder that my CSV files are located in. And now if I click on next, I get this new screen here that lets me transform automatically all this data into a Delta table. I have a couple of configuration options. I can tell you what the delimiter is and if my first row is a header, but that's all I have to do. Like now I can just like create the shortcut as it's a normal flow. And within a few seconds, I start seeing that actual, my data is showing up as a Delta table. So if you see here in the lake house now, after I've refreshed it, I can see that actually now all these records are just in the Delta table. And that's not it, because I showed you like it will keep my data in sync with source. So now I'll just upload a bunch of more CSV files to show you that I don't have to do anything to keep my data in sync. So I'm just adding a bunch more CSV files in here. And as you can see, I'm not doing anything. All I have to do is just go to that Delta table again. I just refresh it real quick to make sure the latest data is there. And if I go there now, I can actually see that more records are showing up in the Delta table. And I did not do anything.
Wow. So no ETL process. I don't need to set up a pipeline. I don't need to write notebooks with Python to, you know, have this going automatically.
Exactly.
It just handles it for me out of the box. So if I have more and more CSV files, if I change the data, it automatically syncs to that Delta data.
Exactly. Everything keeps data in sync with source.
It's like magic. All right. So that's cool. And it's just it's just like any other shortcut that I
just
create.
Like any other shortcut.
Nothing to learn, nothing to do. All right. So that's great. That was a great demo. I love it. I can't wait to get my hands on this. So our world is all about AI these days. We hear it everywhere we go, every corner we turn, every ad on, you know, on TV that we watch. And so I also heard that there's some new capabilities where shortcuts they've gotten a little smarter.
Yeah, definitely. So we started to add these AI-based transformations inside the shortcut experience as well. These are all text-based AI transformations. So very important, you can remove PII from your sensitive data. Yes, very handy that will be.
Yeah, that's very handy.
But also do direct translations, sentiment analysis, key phrase extraction, all the things you do for like your text AI.
So I'm guessing just like the CSV to Delta. This just makes my life easier. It's automatic. I don't need to do a whole bunch of code, you know, write a lot of code or build pipelines. This is just an automatic thing.
Exactly. Easy setup and just like not the change detection. So no ETL pipelines, not managing in different places, just super easy to set up.
All right. So now we know what it is. Yes. I think we should take a look. There's a folder in our lake house that contains call transcript text files. Let's take a look at what these files look like. I need to remove the PII from these files. In most cases, I would probably create a schedule process using a notebook or some other data integration tool to remove this PII. Guess what? Not anymore. All I need to do is create a shortcut. Yes, a shortcut. There's absolutely nothing to it besides a few clicks. Just follow the wizard, select the lake house that contains the folder, select the folder that contains the files, then the magic happens. Simply select the transform that fits your needs. In this case, PII detection. After that, a connection is made. Just to ensure that everyone is looking at the redacted data, I will change the name of the shortcut. Click create, and the PII detection will execute over all the text files. Then, when the team opens any of the files in the new shortcut, all the PII is redacted. Absolutely amazing. But wait, that's not it. If you add more files to the folder, the shortcut detects these changes and automatically detects and redacts the PII. This shortcut is self-maintaining, which means that there is very little work to do and a streamlined process now easily exists for PII detection. Thank you so much, Miquella, for hanging out with us today. I know you're really busy, but we appreciate it. And to all you, thank you so much for taking time out of your day to hang out with us. And as always, if you have any comments, questions, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If this is your first time at the visiting the Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you like our video, hit a big thumbs up. And as always, from Miquella and myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you next Friday.
Thank you everyone for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget to hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you would like to see on the future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive into Microsoft Fabric.